on the lights or this is okay?
This is fine.
Oh no, I
want to
record.
I'm just gonna put random stuff there.
What?
I'm just gonna put random stuff.
That's fine.
He was telling me yesterday how he found him an instructor when he expressed interest in playing the guitar.
Actually, there is a story to that attached to it. He was about to turn 13. Mm-hmm. And he was into these. We had these meetings with these teachers.
Yeah.
We always had him in meetings since he was in kindergarten. And one of the teachers, she made a report, and at the end, she wrote, "I believe this kid has autism."
Okay.
So that impact, what is autism? We have heard of that so much, but we never knew what it was. So we took him to the regional center, and they told us
that. Yeah, the regional center.
Yeah. And they said, yes, he's under the spectrum. He has Asperger's syndrome. And he was, at that time, he was very shy. He wouldn't have no friends, zero friends. Always looking down, just eating. I mean, exactly what an autism kid does. And all this time, we thought it was just that he was too shy. So we feel like a bomb went just right off of under our nose.
I can imagine that being a huge shock. And
yeah.
And I went into a denial mode.
I think that's very understandable.
And my sister got some books and gave it to my wife. My wife left the books on the table every night. And I was like, there's nothing wrong with my son. There's nothing wrong with my son. After like three months later, finally, one day I picked up one of the books.
Okay.
And it was a nonstop. We both, 5 a.m. came to be, and I had read all the books. And I identified myself with many things, and I saw that, my God, what am I doing? My son needs me. So I prayed, and I wonder, well, how can I help my son to get out of this bubble that he was? And I realized that women love musicians.
Yeah. I did not expect you to say that.
and guys, we love to be with a musician because it connects us to women.
Okay, I can see your train of thought there. I can follow.
So
that.
Exactly. So, and not only that, music is a universal language. It doesn't matter.
It's a universal language. You're completely right.
Yeah. So.
That's a good point.
So I started thinking of that. He was just playing his rock band on PlayStation.
Rock band, yeah.
And
oh, yeah.
So and his grandfather had given him an old guitar.
He told me that it was just sitting in the corner right there.
Yeah, with a nylon. So, and I went on Craigslist and I found this teacher from high school, Jonathan, and I called him up. He said he will charge me, I think it was 40 or 50 or 25, I don't remember how much, for 30 minutes, because an hour was too much, and I don't know, let's do 30 minutes, but he gave me an hour free the first time. He came. And then he just looked at me, I think there's some, I got, your son is special, there's something in there. I would like to come back again and teach him. Okay. So he would come.
Hey guys.
Hi there.
Hey.
So he would come. He would come he developed the talent right away, and within 6 months, the professor said, you know what, I cannot keep teaching your son anymore. His skills is off the charts. He's very unique. And next thing I knew, through another person from the school said, hey, I know those ex-singer of Kansas. It's a rock band from 70s, 80s.
Uh-huh.
You know, Kansas, I don't know if you heard that band. He's a singer, so he came into it. He has also a son with autism. And it just fit perfectly.
Oh,
and like,
I love that. What it, it's like a, it's such a, it's so rare, I feel like.
Yeah,
like,
so, so yeah. Since he had a son,
well, those fingers are working well.
Yeah, we're keeping them active.
You told me the other day you thought you couldn't use the fret, but you're doing good. That sounds beautiful.
So, and really that's
good.
How you,
yeah.
You
know,
so
the
pretty.
How
long has it been since you played?
Guitar, like, it was
it's
so beautiful. I cried a bit. Like, it was like so amazing.
Really
he's
nice.
Just still alive with it.
Yeah.
That's just great. He sounds really good.
Yeah.
He was just telling us that his fingers were kind of feeling swollen. He didn't think he could play the guitar.
Yeah.
So I'm really happy to see him playing.
He's not because he's my son, but he's such a great musician. You have to see him alive. He played in a couple of festivals.
Really?
And they will always call him, and I was always like so proud to see so many people getting up just to applaud him. It's like, wow, I like,
yes, talent.
So yeah, the talent.
And you can
and
tell he enjoys it too. I think that's the most obvious thing.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's wonderful.
Gorgeous.
Very nice.
Oh, you look good today. You look
and that opened the door to that people don't even see that he's on the spectrum.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Not
oh,
good.
I can tell. It connects with a lot of people.
Couldn't sleep.
Couldn't sleep last night? What was keeping you awake, Edgar?
My dad said thoughts.
Thoughts? Yeah. Yeah, I know you're just really frustrated and needed to get out of here.
It just sucks because I can't move my tongue so
yeah.
The other way so I can feel in a better position.
Yeah.
Just like my dad and other people are doing.
Yeah.
And I had a stuffy nose.
Oh, the stubby nose is still a problem?
Yeah.
I thought we had that under control with that. Remember we gave the Advil for a few days, no?
No, I have it sounds like in the...
I've been doing the nasal spray.
I have.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, good.
And it's just, I don't know, it's just not working. And I get anxiety. I go make it out.
If I may interject, I believe some of some type of depression has sat in because I mean it's been over a month that we've been here.
Yeah.
And it's boring.
Yeah.
I lost my job.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm here, and you know, which doesn't matter to me. I mean, I already got so many calls, but I'm here and I can see that, you know, that has sat in there and I'm trying to help them to get out of depression more because, I mean, it's like the other doctor came, it's like, wow, I can't believe you made it. It's like, so like I told him like one step at a time, you know, and we'll see where it goes to. And he's anxious to go to get something in the village so mom and dad could be there at the same time and have more freedom to spend time together. And yesterday was a very nice afternoon. We went and it happened that they were doing painting and I painted that for him over there. So
amazing.
Cute.
And I think that helps him a lot. But I think it's
He needs to get out of here.
Yes. He
needs to get out of here.
Don't
stir crazy.
Exactly. I mean, for anybody, even it doesn't matter what condition, anybody will be.
Yeah, I mean, this is how they torture people. They put them in an isolation room.
Yeah.
Right? And it's not isolation because you're here, mom's here, you know, nurses are in and out, but still, you know, you're just stuck in a room for all this time. And I could see a big change in Edgar's mood once he started the physical therapy with, you know, Marco to get out of there and go to the fourth floor. But it's like you get that little taste of freedom and you want more. So we need to work on trying to get you out of here. And I really apologize that it's been taking so hard to take care of the logistics.
It's fine. I mean, today in the morning, I gave him a massage on his back. So try to move so he won't develop, what do you call those?
Bed sores.
Yeah, bed sores.
Yeah.
So So we're doing everything. I've been, he has been doing bowel movements. I came him today. Mm-hmm. So we'll help as much as we can here. Yeah. So we're not just here, just like looking at
yeah,
which
yeah,
so.
Good.
So, okay. And,
all right, and can we take a look at you and then we'll let you get back to playing? Can I touch your guitar?
Yes.
Or can we just move it out of the way?
Yes, it's hard.
Looks like it's really precious. I want to make sure.
It's hard.
He has like, what, like seven?
Seven guitars?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's hard.
Beautiful.
And he has these very expensive ones at home.
Okay.
Like over $1,000 guitar, but.
Oh, okay.
This is Arma for me.
Yeah, it's
just sore everywhere, that's all.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, just laying down in one side only, so.
Yeah.
Like I said today, I was giving him a massage today, and I felt that he's like, I was just caressing and giving him a small massage, so it will help him.
Yeah, massaging the muscle and
mm-hmm.
everything.
And
is your bowel soft, right? Not diarrhea, right?
It's soft, but he's doing now a little bit more regularly, like, you know, a little bit hard. Not too hard,
okay.
But it's still soft, but
okay.
not diarrhea, not
okay.
At all.
Perfect. You want me to put this flesh back on your worry to your neck?
No, I got it.
Let's go pick out your pick one too, just to make sure that we okay here too. It's kind of lifting me up, or we'll have the nurse too.
Yeah.
Do a dressing change.
And did they figure out something to put around that lump on your foot so it wouldn't get?
Mm-hmm. I asked the nurse to do it.
Yeah, so you know, we were talking yesterday about mm-hmm. taking a Duoderm, like a Duoderm patch, cutting a hole in the middle of it, and putting a couple of Duoderm patches around this so that it's protected.
I wonder if it's better to use like a Methylex or something instead and cut a hole in that.
Yeah, maybe I'm using the wrong word, doing it, but you know, something that's like a thick pad,
yeah.
Cut a hole in the middle, like a donut, so that that doesn't rub
Nathan.
Against something or pop.
Let me talk to Nathan, the nurse, about it.
Yeah.
Give him a heads up about it, yeah.
Yeah. Methylex is good.
Yesterday.
It kind of looks
yeah.
like foam, like a thick foam.
Yeah,
and
I think the gray one. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then
yeah.
we have to put multiple ones, like a sandwiches of those to cover that, but not to cover that up, just leave it out.
Okay, let me talk to Nathan about
okay.
it. Yeah.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
Especially because we're talking, you know, about moving, when he's being transported to go to the village,
yeah.
we don't want to knock that.
Do you guys have an idea of when that's going
to
happen?
We'll
I know
talk to the case manager.
The case manager.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I don't know if it was because of the insurance thing, but
mm-hmm.
I think it's already resolved.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
that's resolved. Yeah.
Yeah, but that is resolved already. I already checked my email. They haven't texted me. I mean, they needed the Dr. Aldo's signature and one of the forms which he was missing.
Oh, well, I can put the signature on the form. Yeah.
It's required the
only
hematologist. Yeah.
Okay, I'm a hematologist.
I don't know. Sorry, doctor. Not trying to mean
what they're
saying.
We're calling.
Yeah, all I'm saying is that they, because they saw his name, so they were asking for him.
Oh, they put his name on, so they want his. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's been resolved.
Okay. We'll work on it.
Mm-hmm.
So, Edgar, that song you were playing, that was Places I Remember, right? There are places.
Yeah.
The Beatles, it's a Beatles
song?
Who does that song?
Sorry. So I'll just start out. There are places I remember all my life. There's some I've seen, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, there's some remain. All these places have their moments. For lovers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. In my life, I love you more. But of all these confess to you. And these memories, they lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for lovers and friends, I still can't recall. I know I ought to stop and think about them. In my life, I love you more.
Thank you, son.
I don't have a good voice.
It's okay.
It's great.